Racism. I ain't hooked up in all that racism shit. My motto is life is just be happy with motherfuckers. I ain't into all that racism shit. Racism ain't as bad as it used to be anyway, man. I mean, it's fucked up, but they don't call niggas niggas no more and shit. White people don't say it, especially when it's niggas around, so I guess I wouldn't know. I went to Texas, though, looking for racism about 2 months ago. I had a showdown in Texas, got off the plane and shit. Walked up looking for racism, but my friends always told me, you better not go to Texas. They'll fuck you up. And when the mother, my modern day brother here, that shit, they be like this, what? They ain't fucking nobody up. Brothers act like they couldn't have been slaves back 200 years ago. It ain't like them motherfuckers like that shit. I wish I was a slave. I would fuck somebody up. Shit, tell me to bail some motherfucking cotton. I would have been on the street and shit. You would have came up and said, hey, yo, nigga, bail this cotton. Oh, said, suck my dick, master. Suck my motherfucking dick. That's right, I ain't bailing the motherfucker. It wasn't like that shit. The first dude that got off the boat said that shit. Bail that cotton. Fuck you, motherfucker. The other motherfucker said, we'll bail the shit. Just keep that shit over. Just keep that fucking shit away from me. I got off the motherfucking plane, walked off, got up, walked up my bag, all my black shit on, black leather, big ass medallion and shit on like this. Little white dude walked up and said, this your bag? I said, yeah, it's my fucking bag. Why, motherfucker? A black man can't have a suitcase? This dude was like, what the fuck's wrong with this guy? Wasn't that bad at all, and shit. I'm winded. I'm out of breath. I'm sweating and shit. Y'all, they know I was a ventriloquist, too. Shit ain't as bad as it used to be. All that rage. You know who get it real bad now? Chinese people. They the only ones that be getting fucked over bad. You be teasing them and shit. Ever go in the restaurant and order up some food, and Chinese dude be in there, and then when he leave, you go like this. Everybody makes fun of the Chinese when they order some food up and shit. And they nice guys, they be all cordial shit. I'll humpback, yeah, the egg for young and they get me. When they leave, you go, I'm okay, I'm on the one. I'm in the other table. Your friends and shit be laughing and he look out the back and say, that food is coming right up. Thank you. The food is coming right up. They'd probably be in the back watching us go and say,
yes, very funny. Very funny. Make a special wonton soup for him.
I wonder if they have like a McDonald's in China. The Chinese people be walking and saying, give me a Big Mac and a strawberry shake, a large order fry and a cherry pie. And dude say, Big Mac, strawberry shake, large order fries, cherry pie, coming right up. And when they leave, Chinese do go, Big Mac and a large order of fries and a cherry pie. That's a fucked up language too, Chinese. Hard to learn. I want to learn how to speak Spanish. That's the shit. You know what I really learn how to speak? I'd like to learn how to speak French because that's some cool shit, French. You can say I got a shit in French it'll sound good.
What is in that water? Yeah, poo-poo.
Just sound good, man. I don't like that shit, that Arabic that the motherfuckers be speaking in the 7-Eleven. That shit fuck with me. It sound nasty and shit. We're getting all this hakan the hakan. Hakan. That the hakan in my. But the hakan. That's a word in Arabic. That means some shit to them. They be walking out to you going.
Can I have a ham and cheese hero? Never mind, man. I don't want no hocking on my bread, motherfucker. That's all right.
Spanish, the language. You know, I want to learn how to speak Spanish? Because I was always a Ricky Ricardo buff. I thought when he would get mad at Lucy and be saying, curse it. I said,
go on, Ricky. Curse the bitch out.
Ricky would lose his mind. Ricky was cool and shit. For the 50s, Desi Arnaz, Ricky Ricardo was a cool motherfucker. He had his baggies on and pointy shoes and the Club Babaloo and shit.
My horse on the carriage, he's for hire, senora. For yes, as long as you desire, senorita. We're gonna ride, forget the manana, and come to Havana with me. And my Cuban cabin.
Remember that shit? You be sitting there like this. He had a cool ass laugh too. I would like him to go, it's just so ridiculous. Hey Fred, how would you like to fuck me up the ass? TV is all screwed up. Any kids here? I mean, little kids. I know a lot of people bring their little kids down here. How old are you, man? How old? 30. Oh, you're going to be fucked up when you leave.
Dad, what's a dick? What is that?
How old's the other dude right there? Oh, y'all fucked up now. Y'all thought I would be going like this. Okay, and all that shit, right? You ain't know I'd be saying, our dick is this big. Kids gonna be waking up like this.
The Negro's dicks are coming to get me, Mom!
I'm gonna tell y'all a little joke y'all can tell in school, all right? Just cause I've been telling this dirty stuff. Okay? Here's a little joke for y'all. Y'all can listen to it too. But I know lots of times people see my show, then go to work and try to tell my act and fuck my jokes up on the job and shit.
And, said, and then he said, Goonie Google. And he had a G.I. Joe up his ass. Hey, I'm Mr. T. I'll rip your cock off with my ass. And dude be standing going, yeah, that's very funny shit.
Here's a joke that you can tell down at school when school starts. Everybody be quiet now. Are you listening, guys? A bear and a rabbit are taking a shit in the woods. And the bear turns to the rabbit and says, excuse me, do you have problems with shit sticking to your fur? And the rabbit says, no. So the bear wiped his ass with the rabbit.
I like that joke.
Anybody got cable? I've been watching a lot of cable lately because I'm so mad at the only good show on TV now is Star Trek. That's some good shit. I like Captain Kirk and shit. Captain Kirk will fuck anybody. I seen him beam down the planet. Ever see that episode where he fucked this green bitch? You gotta be a horny motherfucker to fuck a green bitch. I mean, I ain't no racist, but if the bitch is green, there's something wrong with the pussy. He be fucking the music, be going, dun, 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 boom, 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 dun, 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 dun. Shit be getting all fucked up. Mr. Scott, I like him, he made me laugh. He never cool and shit. He's the opposite of Spock. The shit be all fucked up, and Mr. Scott would say,
Captain, my ship can't take much money, sir. She's about to blow.
Let Spock handle it.
And Spock say, Mr. Scott, why don't you take the phasers and point them at the dilithium crystals and point them phasers at them and use the power from the phasers to regenerate the dilithium crystals and we can get out on impulse power.
Mr. Spock, it just might work, sir.
The shit worked last week, motherfucker.
I got fed up with TV and shit because I seen all the Star Treks. I started watching cable. I was watching Poltergeist last month. I got a question. Why don't white people just leave the house when there's a ghost in the house? Y'all stay in the house too fucking long. Get the fuck out of the house. Very simple. It's a ghost in the house. Get the fuck out. And not only did they stay in the motherfucking house and poltergeist, they invited more white people over. Sitting around going, our daughter Carol Ann's on the television set. I would have been gone. If I had a daughter, been down the precinct saying, look, man, I went home and my fucking daughter's in the TV set and shit, so I just fucking left. You can have all that shit. I ain't going back to the motherfucking, I just came down so when she ain't up at school, you don't think I killed the bitch or nothing like that. But she is inside the TV set. You can have all that shit. Fuck it. Mr. Murphy, didn't you try to save your daughter? Yeah, I'm a man and shit. I tried to save. I turned the channel. The shit didn't work. I got the fuck out. Leave. The kid was only 6 years old in the movie. They couldn't have been too attached to her. Leave. In the Amityville Horror, the ghost told them to get out the house. White people stayed in there. Now that's a hint and a half for your ass. A ghost say get the fuck out, I would just tip the fuck out the door. They walked and looked in the toilet bowl, was blood in the toilet. They said, that's peculiar. I would have been in the house and said, oh baby, this is beautiful. We got a chandelier hanging up here, kids outside playing, it's a beautiful neighborhood. We ain't got nothing to wear. I really love them, this is really nice.
Get out.
Too bad we can't stay, baby. You know, I want to say something. You know, like, I think maybe like 30 years ago, there was a woman that wanted to sing in it, a black lady that sang opera, that wanted to sing, what was her name? Mary Anderson. And this place was like segregated and they couldn't sing here. And she couldn't sing in the place. And here we are, like, you know, not even 50 years later, a 22-year-old black man on stage getting paid to hold his dick. God bless America. I gotta go now. Y'all take it easy. Bye-bye.
That was it, baby. That was it, baby.